Man in the woods. I lived in a rough area as a kid. I had drug dealers that my family shared a wall of our home with many times. People would get assaulted, robbed, and even a few murders happened. Growing up in the late 90s, early 2000s, we'd be outside a lot from spring till end of fall. The houses were organized in giant ovals and they all shared at least two walls with the homes next to each other, unless you lived on the end like we did. We had woods behind us that stretched for a few miles along with a pretty gross lake that no one would even fish in. We used to have forts built into the woods that we'd have to replace every other year due to blizzards destroying them. One summer, a few kids that were related to a neighbor came down from another state. The kids are Matty, Mark, Michael. We decided with the extra hands would be a good time to redo our forts. We, Joe, Rob, Jussie, Matty, Mark, Michael, and I, all decided to wake up really early to gather supplies and begin the walk into the woods. The area of the woods we put our forts in had both a bunch of trees and light from the sun. Besides this old rusty fence in the middle of the woods that went down to part of the lake, nothing else was around. Matty, Mark, and Michael were excited because they were from the city and never really had any chance to freely wander in the woods before. The rest of us, on the other hand, were always in the woods, but this time something was different. The air was changed, and we felt as if we weren't alone. After being out there for 4 hours, we took a break and went to the store near us for snacks. When we got our packs full, we headed back. The same feeling was with us when we went back into the woods. Even most of our supplies we left in the woods, like nails, tape, strings, were all gone. Our friend Joe even lost his bracelet his girlfriend gave him. As the day went on, we didn't think much about it because we're kids having fun. We went back the next day after swimming for a few hours. All of the previous day's work was destroyed. Hours of time spent for nothing. We took the time looking around and found nothing. Not even a sign anyone has been around since we left. School vacation ended, and the kids that were visiting left. A bunch of houses got broken into this year and people thought it was neighbors that had issues with each other. This happened for months on end. After two more months of this happening, people started to realize no one that lived in any of the houses were doing any of it. My area had the most working lights, so only two houses were even close to being broken into. All the parents were on high alert as school was coming to the end for the year. As of July of this year, we had 38 apartments broken into and one unrelated murder. All the kids weren't allowed out past 8 p.m. once it got dark. Matty, Mark, and Michael came down for a short vacation. They decided to go back into the area where we had made forts. I figured because I didn't want to go to the store with my family and had nothing better to do, I'll go too. Every few yards we'd hear something snap a branch, as if we were being followed, but never saw a thing. We didn't find our stuff left over from months prior, but we didn't think we would have anyways. However, we found something else, a campsite. Besides a few ripped pants, a sweater, and just one cameo Nike Air Force sneaker, it was mostly food wrappers and soda bottles. Matty started to freak as he swears he saw someone watching us from the trees near a small creek. They panicked and ran. I didn't see anything, but I ran too. They stayed at Jess's house that night. I have a gravel road behind my house that goes to behind a few other homes, Jess's included. I had Rob stay the night like he almost always did back then. He woke me up in the middle of the night saying that he was hearing someone walking around. He also said that he saw a very tall man in a black hoodie walking away from Jess's house. The next day we found out that someone broke the lights behind the houses and tried getting into Jess's house. Stupidly, we all went back the next day, Joe, Rob, Jussie, Matty, Mark, Michael, and I. We all felt like we were being watched instantly. Jussie fell and hurt his leg badly, so Joe and Mark, being the strongest, brought him home. The rest of us wished we left when they did. We found the camp again and found some shards of glass from the lights with some blood on it. The tent was knocked over, and as we went to leave, that was when this guy in a black and white hoodie with ripped pants and no shoes came running at us from the other side of the woods. None of us got a good look at his face. We split up and went different ways home. I found Mark hiding in a dumpster near my house. We told my family, who were beyond mad. The cops went to the camp and found no man or tent. They found that Nike shoe and the clothes he was wearing when he chased us. We never saw this man's face, but he saw ours. Years later, that part of the woods was bought by a company to make a mini golf course on. They found a rusted shotgun in the woods. The man living in the woods is whom everyone believes is the one breaking into the homes. It makes sense thinking about it now. None of us live there anymore, and sadly one isn't alive anymore. We all remember that event, and the ones that have kids now are really protective of them when they go home to visit our parents who still live in those homes. Someone has tried getting inside my house for the last 2 nights. The dogs are barking again. This happened last night and the night before. A little backstory first. I live in a not too safe area. The block I'm on is okay, but if you walk down my street a block or two you could get shot, offered drugs, be mugged and so much more. When we leave our house we head up a side street that gets us away from trouble. Like I said, my block isn't bad. We all get along here. Most people on this block are related to each other. All but for my household, but even though we are strangers to the neighbors they are nice to us. The people right next door have dogs as well as a few other households. Again, we are the odd ones out in that department as well. The dogs only bark when someone is out on our block that doesn't live here. I have always felt safer because of the dogs. I live in a home converted into a duplex. When you walk in the front door you are in the entryway, and then across the entryway you see my apartment door. Then if you go up the stairs beside my door you will find the door to the second apartment. The front door to the house has no lock mechanism at all. It's so tenants cannot lock each other out of the house. We can only lock the doors to our apartments. When you come into the entryway a motion sensing light comes on. No one is currently living in the upstairs apartment right now. So at this time it's just me and my hubs, husband, living in the place. 2 nights ago hubs was in bed and I was up watching TV. I was all relaxed and thinking about going to bed soon. It was nearly 1 a.m. Suddenly I got this overwhelming uncomfortable feeling. I felt hot and sick in my stomach, and I had the intrusive thought that I needed to check the apartment door to make sure it was locked. I tried to brush it off but I couldn't. So I got up to look. Just as I got there I heard someone open the screen door on the outer house door. I looked and the door was locked. Then I heard the actual door of the house open and someone step into the entryway. I was terrified. I know no one lives upstairs and my landlord said he would let me know if someone was moving in. We don't get visitors this late or without a phone call first. Also, with this pandemic and social distancing no one should be coming over. Then I heard a click. I recognize the click as the sound the motion light makes when it turns on. Then I hear a male voice say "oh shit" and the sound of someone running out of the house. I was terrified. I stood there trying to process what just happened. From the time I heard the screen door open until a solid minute after the person ran out I stood there frozen. The neighborhood dogs were barking their heads off all that night. And they only do that if someone is around that they don't know. I think that someone who doesn't know that the house is a duplex attempted to let themselves in. The light, which is way too bright for that tiny entryway, came on and scared the person away. I woke up hubs and we called the police. They said that since the person was not trying to get into my apartment exactly, they weren't coming out. The best they would do is drive by a few times. Yeah, real comforting. Last night I was again up late. The dogs were barking like crazy yet again. At a little after midnight I hear a noise. I mute the TV. I realize someone is pounding, not knocking, but full on pounding on the outer house door. Not my apartment door, thank goodness. I was freaked out. I wanted to go in and wake up the hubs, but thought better of it. There is a window beside the outer house door where he was knocking, and that window is our bedroom window. Because hubs were sleeping and the lights were on in the living room but off in the bedroom, I thought if I opened the door the person standing on the porch hammering on the door would see the light and then know someone was here, and I was afraid to let whoever was out there to know someone was here. I sat here for over 10 minutes of banging. It was not stopping. I thought maybe it was the police because of the call I made the night before, so I called the police and told them what was happening and about what happened the night before and about my call to them the night before, and I asked could it be police at my door. He looked into it and said that as far as he could tell whoever it was not police. He also said not to open the door. He said he was sending police out, and if someone was still banging on the door they would talk to them, and he said he would call when he knew what was going on. The banging stopped about 5 minutes after hanging up with the police dispatcher, but I never got a phone call. So I don't know if the police ever showed up. Tonight the dogs are already barking and have been for the past hour. My hubs decided that I'm going to bed early and he is staying up. I doubt I will sleep anyways. I made him promise that no matter what he hears he won't unlock and open our front door. If there are any more shenanigans tonight I will update here in this post. Quick question. Is it smart to not advertise the fact that we are here, not having lights on in the bedroom, and not going to the bedroom window to get a look at this person? Or should we make clear that people do in fact live here? And who knows, it could have been two different people here on two consecutive nights at around the same time, between 12 and 1 a.m. I just hope to never meet this person.